Okay. So now we know we have many thousands, and tens of thousands of people in this structure, in the different parts of this structure.
Right.
There are 9 out of those tens of thousands of people that are required to be male. Right?
Right.
And all the others of the many tens of thousands are not. And some of them have more females in that body, and some
right.
of them have more males in that body. And right, there's all kinds of mixes
right.
because it's all around the planet.
Right.
So I think it'd be appropriate, since we're talking about this structure here, and I noticed on your slide you said that, that out of all those many tens of thousands, 9 are required by Baha'u'llah to be male. And I wondered what you wanted
to
say.
Do you want to comment on that?
Yeah.
I don't have a reason for that, but I can tell you that the Baha'u'llah is that only the Universal House of Justice members have to be male.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know the reason for that. Emily?
On the talk given by, remember there was talk?
There was a Universal House of Justice member at the National Convention in Hoover Dunbar.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Retired member, and he talked about that, and Emily was
yes.
there, I was not there for that.
Half asleep, but I still remember it.
Okay.
He talked about, like, that was a reason that we discover when the time was right, when we were, when we could understand it. Like, that's why we're revealed different things, because we have different levels of understanding now. We're able to comprehend more.
Mm-hmm.
And when we're able to comprehend why that is, then the reason will be revealed to us.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a reason for what we know about it.
For us, we may have.
Yeah.
Just that word. I don't know why either.
Just for the universe class of justice. Any other one could be anything.
I must say that, speaking of that, since we're speaking of gender, that Baha'is...
Can I add it to something for the question?
Yes, go ahead.
Well, as you mentioned, nobody at the moment understands why.
Mm-hmm.
But when Mr. Fruta, the hand of the cause, was in our house in Tehran, mm-hmm. and one lady asked him, Mr. Bhutan, why Baha'u'llah deprived women do you being of the member of the Universal House Justice? He answered, I don't think he deprived. He excused you of the hard worker that member has it.
Mm-hmm.
That member in future, I know, you have a lot of work, a lot. When, imagine, as the man said, thousands of involved. But now in future, when people would come to that, the women have some duty at the house, baby, children, and problem. That's why for that, only that institute, he excused them, not deprived them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That is what.
Excellent, very good.
Can I add to that? For my very, very limited knowledge, and continuing on that thought, Baha'u'llah, the first tablet that Baha'u'llah revealed that has not been translated into English, Qasidah al-Shamah, Baha'u'llah describes himself, his own inner being, as a female entity. And there are many tablets of Baha'u'llah in which his inner spiritual being is a female entity. So the higher station of a being is a female. And to me, it's an honor to be not in the Universal House of Justice. Women have a higher calling than being busy with the work that
yeah.
also men can do. Mm-hmm. They have more important things to do.
Mm-hmm.
That's my very personal view, including education of children, nurturing the community, and all those, the compassion, the love, the unity that usually a female qualities bring about.
Actually, it appears to me that there that more women, women are more involved in teaching the cause than men. I see more, I mean, I don't see all the other countries, but I can tell you that I see women doing, frankly, a lot more than us guys. We gotta get